The total approved budget for this financial year is 52.736 trillion shillings. The Minister of Finance has today released 16% of these funds, representing a total of 4.833 trillion shillings. This is the first quarter expenditure of this financial year, and it has basically catered for wages, pension and capitation grants for schools, purchase of essential medicines, universities, road maintenance and catering for arrears.
Number two, all accounting officers are required to ensure that they pay wages, salaries and pension and gratuity by the 28th of every month, starting with this month of July.
In a simple breakdown, 1.824 trillion shillings has been allocated to the wage budget. 169.968 billion shillings is to cater for payment of pension for the retired civil servants. 147.778 billion shillings to cater for gratuity. Under the education sector, the capitation grants for schools have been fully provided for the third term, while 9.13 billion shillings has been provided to universities in line with the semester requirements, and part of this will go to Makerere University, Chambogo, MOBS, Uganda Management Institute and Gulu University. 44 billion shillings has been allocated for road maintenance under the local governments, translating to 250 million per local government. 10.446 billion shillings has been provided to cater for arrears, while 140.241 billion shillings has been allocated to the national medical stores for the purchase of essential medicines and drugs, among others.
Instead of borrowing beyond our optimal levels, we shall, whenever necessary, reduce expenditure for activities that do not add to the value of the economy or the well-being of Ugandans. In particular, we shall not borrow at interest cost that is too high, especially in the domestic market. Government will continue to explore new financing initiatives. That last financial year enabled us to reduce our financing cost.
A strong caution has been sounded to the accounting officers to ensure the effective implementation of this budget. They have also been asked to desist from carrying out any recruitments without clearance from the Ministry of Public Service.
Accounting officers are required to ensure that every promotion and redeployment of staff made to a different cost center is backed up by adequate wage provision.
Chair, you may recall that a number of MDAs returned back the money in the last financial year, 2021-2022. In fact, we are told that 13.6 billion was returned to the Treasury by the OPM due to low absorption capacity in the financial 2021-2022. And definitely this affects delivery of services.
The Permanent Secretary of the Ministry of Finance, Ramadan Gobi, has reported a steady recovery of the economy since the COVID-19 pandemic. The growth is estimated at 5.3% from 4.6% in 2021-2022. This has been attributed to the reduction in inflation, agricultural sector recovery, among others. Report compiled by Jaliat Namuwaya for the news.